Okay, so this bit might well be some of the worst game design I've ever seen, I think. We're entering a heat sensor area. So let's just open the door and see what's what. So, my first thought was, right, red is bad. We all know that red is bad in games. It's got little heat logos on it, so clearly that's heat sensors, right? If we stand on them, then we'll trigger detection. But no, turns out it's the cameras and the robots that are doing all the heat seeking. And what this bit is a heat block which gives off heat and thus disguises the fact that we're lurking next to it. Now, why in the hell would this ever be a thing that exists? Honestly, what is the deal? Why would you have blocks on the floor that just give off heat and disable your security systems? It's ridiculous. I'm not even sure if these things can see or if they're purely heat-based. They might just be heat-based. In which case they're kind of motion detectors more than anything. So let's just take our time and stroll through all careful like. Right, so we've got another one in front of us. But yeah, even when we're sat in front of it. Oh. It doesn't seem to know what to do when we're not moving. Lovely. That's the door open. Okay, so we're through. Now what? We've got security terminals down below. That's promising.
Commencing with systems check in server chamber 204.
We didn't bring a bunch of hacking stuff to not use it, so let's do some hacking, shall we? Now, so we're going up there. Yeah, we've got two different reds to worry about.
Anomaly detected.
So we need to fortify them.
Initiated.
Fortify that. I think we've done enough fortifying to help us out. So we can capture that one. Capture that. We've actually got time to capture the data store, I think. Yeah, that wasn't so hard.
Access granted.
Now, what will that let us turn off? Cameras. Drones. Turrets, of course. And it lets us open vault doors.
Running diagnostics check.
Sweet. So that may have turned off pretty much everything that was going to cause us trouble. But we've also got this second security terminal, so what's the deal? Ooh, look at all that. So we can capture them all, perhaps. Wow.
Access granted.
Nice. 300 XP and some softwares. Cool. Now, you are doing different cameras. Okay. And a different drone and different turrets. And are you opening different doors for us? One would assume so. Cool. So are there any threats left in here? Maybe. We've got a new Praxis, but just the one. We only got one available. Shame. Is it worth holding on to it? Probably not at this point. I doubt we're going to get any more Praxis after this. Extra HP? Could come in handy. So, let's have a look around. This could have been tricky, I guess, without everything switched off. As it is. Perhaps not. Okay, we need an authorized passport to get in the control server room. Whatever that might be. Let's just have a good old scope out of this ground floor first, I think, and then we'll worry about upstairs. Right, so it doesn't seem to be much terribly worthwhile on that ground floor. What have we up here? 201 is that way. It was 4 and 9 that we needed, wasn't it? Yep. That one's just got laser grids and whatnot. So we won't worry too much about that one for now. 2 and 9, that was the optional one, yes? Gas. Right, so we've got no real way of dealing with gas. But we did just buy a bigger health bar, so maybe that'll help us. Alright, a couple of hyperstims. Has that actually increased our health beyond normal? Maybe. You got any loot for us in here? Anything at all? Let's have a look. I'm not seeing anything around. I'm also not seeing any valves. And we're out of stuff. Okay. It was definitely worth saving my praxis, I feel. Until I knew where I was going to need to spend it. Because it might be the case that we just cannot complete that side quest now without the lungs augmentation. It's a shame, there's literally no other way around gas other than using the rebreathers, so I guess we need to leave that. And maybe we'll get another praxis? I mean, it seems like I've quick-saved at some point, we've actually got a praxis back, but maybe we can get enough for another by just doing the main quest. Right, so lasers over there, but we can sneak in here. Running dive. What's that done for us? It has got us a good chunk of XP. Not quite enough for another level,
Richard,
though.
The passport's plugged into Santos' server. You getting anything?
Hang on. I'm accessing the file. It's empty. I mean, the data was here, but it's been moved. Looks like to some kind of mainframe.
Ooh. Is Palisade stealing Santos' files?
We need to find that mainframe. The data's being sent there through a private workstation. Masaki Oshiro's.
Uh-huh.
The transfer is using micro-connection, so it must be near you. Find it, and you'll find the mainframe.
It'll probably require a higher security clearance.
I'll upgrade the passport while I'm linked to it. Just give me a second, then you can remove it. Okay, Jensen. I'm out.
That took more than a second, Francis. But there we go. We've got a level 10 passport now. Now we can enter the private work area of Ishiro, perhaps. Let's see. And we're in. And there we go, that has given us another praxis. Fantastic.
Diagnostic sequence complete.
So now that we've got two, lungs. Now that we've got lungs, back to 204. 209. You know what I meant. Let's see, we've got a holographic display table. What else have we got in here? I'm going to need some more battery in a moment. Because I can't seem to find anything. Yeah, it's not entirely clear what's happening in here. Or why there's gas, or where the gas is coming from. It was room 209. Inspect server chamber 209. Yeah. There's nothing out here I need to inspect, is there? Oh, there we go. There was a valve the whole time. I'm a big idiot. Shocking, I know. Now.
Running diagnostics check in sector 11759.
Aha!
Diagnostic sequence complete.
So, we found another pocket secretary. And sent message. A bug in the system, moving all our clients' new data to Blade mainframe. Okay, so it looks like she was halfway through writing that message when everything went
about
wrong.
This, Pritchard. According to an email I just found, Masaki Yoshiro ordered Saradakis to run maintenance in the chamber that killed her.
Shadow Child was right, Ben. There is a lot going on inside that bank. Finish the mission and we'll see what we can do about it.
We will. But for now, what we need to do is head into here.
Voice recognition is ready.
Voice recognition?
Diagnostics check of hydraulic system.
Something tells me that it's not coded to Adam's voice. We've got a compute. It's got a security code of 1. Come now. You can do better than that. And I think we've done it.
Access granted.
Lovely. So, hacker report. Top 10 hackers are still at large. Shadow Child, Janus, yeah. Housecat, they sound cool. Baba Yaga 50, origin unknown. Antonin Baba. I assure you I have no connection to Baba Yaga 50. Yeah, I can see why people might think that he does. Nico has sent him a mail. You will pay. I'll not accept any of the money you are throwing at me. Justice is coming for you. I mean, if I had got an email like this, I'd just delete it. Now, what's Leona got to say? Nothing major. Okay. So there wasn't much of use on that compute by the look of it. Oh.
Calm down. I can see the headlight. Masaki Yoshiro and his life's work now worthless. Dowd knew everything. He even knew details about Saradakis' death.
I think Stanton made a lucky guess and your reaction sealed it. It doesn't matter. We're on their radar now. That's what matters. Not some dead body.
But they want complete access to everyone's files. We only look at client files when we make investments. Adding the people that Dowd represents to our insider trading scheme doesn't make it safe.
Just think of what we will get in return from them.
You're missing the point, Ashani. They'd have total access.
Are you still recording? I swear, I don't understand why you insist on...
Why does he insist on recording all of his conversations? I mean, it helps
Voice us. Recognition is ready.
Masaki Yoshiro...
Voice analysis in progress. Voice recognition confirmed. Welcome, Mr. Yoshiro.
Pritchard, Yoshiro and Talwar have been engaging in insider trading. That's why data's being moved. I think Simona Saradakis caught on to them.
And they killed her to shut her up?
The recording I found mentioned a Stanton Dowd who might also be involved.
Get me connected to the mainframe. Maybe I can find out more when I'm inside.
Maybe so. And now we've got even more praxis. They're really throwing it at us now at the end of this. So let's see. Efficient recharge rate. Maximum storage capacity could be useful. Because we might need to use our cloaking abilities to get out.
Richard, what's it looking like on your end?
We were right. Santos' files are here. I'm gonna extract what I need. Shit.
Yeah.
Jensen.
Good job, Richard.
The AI core is cutting off my communications.
Richard?
Santos trapped, Jensen. I can't get to the exit. Shadow Child. She may be.
His avatar is trapped.
Virus detected.
What? What? What does any of this mean? I feel like we're in trouble.
Shadow Child, I've got a situation. I lost contact with Nuclear Snake and the NSN, and the Blade security system fried the passport.
What? That's bad. Very, very bad. Without the passport Signa, our friend's avatar has no way out of the NSN. They'll be able to use its signature to pinpoint his location.
Is there something I can do? There's an NSN chair here connected to the mainframe.
Really? Yes. I might be able to open a gateway for him if I hack into the Palisades network using your infolink frequency.
How does any of this work?
I might be the only hacker in history who can, but now is not the time for bragging. Just sit in the chair and I'll do the rest.
We can do that. We can sit in the chair. I feel like we're capable of such feats.
Child, I'm in. I don't have eyes on Nuclear Snake's avatar.
This is incredible. Mr. Jensen, the Palisades mainframe is unlike any NSN server I've seen before. Okay. From what I can tell, you're in a partition of the mainframe server. I see traces of two avatars in the code. The other one must be our friend.
Cool. So, let's go find Pritchard, I guess. What sort of shape is that? It's like a triangle, but top's cut off. Yeah. Trapezoid? Trapezoid? Maybe. I don't trust it as much as triangles. Ooh. This all looks very fancy. I'm enjoying it.
I see him, Shadow Child. His avatar is out of reach. It doesn't seem like I can communicate with him.
That's because the Palisades virtual defense systems are interfering with his connections. If you extract the program from the data towers in this server, it should disable the system's hold on him.
Sounds easy enough.
I took the liberty of applying a few augments to your avatar that may come in handy. In the meantime, I'll work on opening a gateway for him to use as an exit point.
Cool. So if you added remote hacking, I guess we can't reach all the way over there, so we'll have to fanny about. Oh. In these side rooms. I don't know, has that just led us in a circle? Well, not a circle, per se. It's just led us to the same place. So, yeah, we can't seem to reach over there. But continuing through these just leads us back to the same room we were in. Yeah. So we can't open that door. We can't drop off there without dying, I assume. We can't do the big jumps. So what's the play here? Are we supposed to be able to reach that? Okay. Falling off the cliff is not the play. Colour me stumped. I am at a loss once again. Does my quest log help me? I don't know, because we can't actually look at it. A bit more of a clue as to what the hell's going on would have been nice, Shadow Child. But I guess you're a busy woman. You've got things to do. I feel like it wants me to interact with that. But I can't interact with that, because I don't seem to have any remote hacking buttons available.
346 minutes later.
Yeah. I was wondering why we had smart vision as an option. Very well. Oh. Okay. That wasn't terribly well explained. I guess that was the puzzle, though.
The toughest I've ever encountered. The AI core is adapting and fighting back every attempt I make to open a gateway.
Keep at it. I'm still working on extracting the data from these towers.
So, do we have to stay in this stinko smart vision the whole time? I'd rather not, because it looks like ass. But we can press a button. Now. Okay, smart vision's not helping now. That's good. Wireless control box. Oops. what's that done for us? It's moving around. It's dropped a box. Good. That puzzle was more straightforward. In that I realised it was actually a puzzle.
This isn't working, Mr. Jensen. The Blade's AI core is thinking too fast, preventing me from creating a stable gateway into the mainframe.
We need another way then.
And I may have one. I can create a hole in the outer defences and invite a few of my Ripper friends to attack the client servers at the same time.
Cause a distraction elsewhere and the AI looks away from the mainframe.
Yeah.
Smart.
I should warn you.
Flood the system.
Nuclear Snake will not be happy about it.
He doesn't get a vote. Do it.
Yeah, fuck that guy. Now, we have got a tunnel down there. Do we have anything? Ah, yeah. So that creates a bridge which takes us out part way. And then we drop the box. Okay, where are we supposed to be dropping the box? Oh, we are dropping it in there. It's just it's going back and forth. Very well. Oops. That's no good. It's tricky because you've got to line it up, but at the same time, if it's not over the thing when it lines up, then it's not good enough. So you've got to hope that they synchronize, basically. The box's movement from side to side, and the spot on the remote hacking device. Now, where's this taking us? We want to be over there. Platforming. That's what we all want in our Deus Ex games. Getting tricky now. Oh. Oh. Damn it. Well, we did it. Good. And now we need to get out of smart vision. Okay. But now we should probably get back in it so we can get back partway across. And then just about make the jump onto there.
Sure as hell hope that's you.
Might be.
Yeah, it's me.
Well, this look is an improvement, that's for sure. If it isn't obvious by now, our covert mission is screwed.
Yeah,
every
pretty much.
Every Ripper in the world is probably attacking the Blade servers as we speak.
Time and options were not on our side. Did you find what we were looking for?
Hopefully. I'll know after I start analyzing the files back in the real world.
So you don't even know if you've succeeded. I suppose we'll worry about that later. Survival now is the goal.
Shadow Child, Nuclear Snake is out. Shadow Child?
Alright. Hopefully she's not been compromised. But we need to escape, I think. Something's not right here. Computer's locked again. Well, now we can't get into it because there's no hacking option, and we haven't actually got our inventory back either. It's kind of worrying. Right, is there anything in here that's different to the last time we were in here? there anything untoward? Anything that looks odd or out of place? We've got smart vision again. Right, okay, so it highlights the computer, but it doesn't change anything. Oh wait, there we go. We haven't actually left yet. Very clever. Now we're back in the real world, I think.
There you are, Mr. Jensen. I lost connection with you for a moment. Are you out of the NSN yet?
Yes,
so I think so.
Good. I've been working on an escape option for you. There is a maintenance hatch on the underside of the blade. It's a quick exit, but also a long drop to the river.
It's that or I leave the way I came in. Fight or fall, I guess.
Exactly. Get to your apartment. There are things we need to discuss. Shadow Child, you and I also need to talk. Privately.
Okay, Nukes. The mainframe door is open, Mr. Jensen. I'll keep working on getting that exterior hatch unlocked.
Thanks.
Now, Shadow Child.
Right, so we have not got the ability to drop safely, I don't think. Are we going to get any more Praxis? Because we need two for Icarus, don't we? Yeah. So we might have to go the way we came in. And if everything's switched back on out here, that could be problematic. Yeah. I'm seeing robots. So let's try and sneak our way to safety. Okay, I'm not seeing everything lit up. But there are a few robots about. You've seen nothing, my friend. Just go about your business. There's clearly nothing here. I guess crouching's not really necessary around here. It's just all about speed.
Is unlocked. Buona fortuna, Mr. Jensen.
I appreciate your help, but how are you still connected to the Blade systems?
Just be thankful that I am, and get out while you still can, my friend.
Nearly got spotted there. Okay, let's try gluing ourselves to this box. And then this box. Still doesn't make a lick of sense why you would have this sort of system in your place, just obviating your heat sensor mechanics. But there we go. We'll take advantage of it. Now, can we make it over there? Just about. Can we make it up the stairs? Yeah. I'm guessing the security is no longer of any use to us, so out we go. So how did we do this before? And can we do it again? No, that robot's going that way now. So I guess we just stroll down here. Oh wait, there's a hatch. We need the hatch now. Yep, go about your business. Okay, once again, robot thinks he's seen. So let's just wait a moment. Let him bugger off. Okay, you're going over there. And turns out we didn't need Icarus. Good.
We meet again, Mr. Jensen.
I see you made yourself at home.
You let yourself into my place, I let myself into yours.
Yeah, it's fair.
You know, you can tell a lot about a person by how clean they keep their home when they are not expecting visitors. I wonder what the police will think of mine.
You're sure they traced you then?
It's only a matter of time. What we accomplished tonight, punching through the Palisades defenses. The breach is going to help us expose everyone's dirty little secrets.
Sweet.
The breach? You mean you didn't close the hole you made?
Why would I? Besides, it's not possible. Word of what we did is spreading through the darknet like wildfire. Reapers will be attacking the Palisade servers day and night to get at the truth. This is a good thing, Mr. Jensen. It's what we wanted.
Yeah, I can live with that.
I wanted to find out what's really going on inside the bank. And in the end, we barely scratched the surface. I look forward to seeing what others will find out.
This will change things. At this very minute, thousands of Reapers are accessing data in small amounts. It's a tiny crack in a dam, but it can grow and maybe even bring the Palisade Bank Corporation and its founders down.
Good.
Let's hope so. Tell me something. Now that you don't have an apartment anymore, what's next?
My partner and I are debating. We're either moving to California wine country or Argentina. One thing is for sure though, Shadow Child's time in Europe is over.
Argentina would be nice.
And now I must go. Nuclear Snake is very upset about the breach. I think I will be mending fences with him for a long time. How do you tell someone like that they need therapy?
You don't.
Ciao, Mr. Jensen.
See you later, Chick.
Ciao.
Well, it looks like you and I made it out cleanly, Jensen. The authorities haven't identified us.
That's a win.
Shadow Child might not be so lucky. She's leaving town.
Between you and me, I think she wanted things to trace back to her. There were other options. This was supposed to be a small investigation into Santo. Instead, thanks to her, we're responsible for the Woodstock of hacking.
Nice.
She helped get you out. Regardless, are you forgetting what we found out in there?
That Oshiro and Talwar murdered Simona Saradakis to keep their elaborate insider trading scheme from going public?
And that this Stanton Dowd person is blackmailing them to get access to every client's files. Did you find anything on him?
Only that there isn't much to go on. He's an old money trillionaire who's more skilled at breaking even than he is at making a profit.
There must be more, Pritchard. Oshiro seemed especially concerned about the people Dowd represents.
It's gotta be Illuminati.
If you want me to, I'll keep digging. But right now, we're sitting on an open and shut case against the bank's founders.
Except we can't release the evidence ourselves because we obtained it illegally.
Well, that's what the darknet's
for. Precisely. So what do you think we should do about it?
We could give it to him, but then he'll just get murdered by the bank's founders.
Let's release what we have on the darknet. The world needs to know that the Palisade Bank is a sham. Maybe the investigation will take on a life of its own.
Hopefully.
Once Reapers like Shadow Child get a hold of it, it probably will.
That may be Simona Saradakis' best chance for justice.
If you say so.
What about you and your client? Did you find anything incriminating in Santo's files?
I'm still analyzing them. So far, their plans for Rabia look legitimate. The timetable seems very aggressive, though.
It has to be. If the Human Restoration Act passes, a lot of augmented people have no choice but to move there.
That could be good or bad, depending. I hope it doesn't come to that, Jensen. For any of us.
Hopefully.
Me neither. Well, as enjoyable as this little escapade of yours has been, I need to...
To get back to that moody loner thing you do so well. I understand completely. Besides, I have a report to file with my client.
You're gonna thank me?
You know, Jensen, this may be the last time we ever work together. Assuming, of course, you don't get yourself half-killed, saving the world again, and call on me to
Goodbye, Francis.
Duh. He was about to say something nice, Adam.
Take care of yourself.
Hey, there we go. So I guess that was System Rift. It was bigger than I was expecting. The reviews were mixed on Steam, and I assume that was just because it was small for the price. But yeah, that was a good full-size chunk of DLC, so I'm pleased with that. Seeing Pritchard again was fun. Once I figured out what the hell was going on with those heat sensors, that mechanic was okay. And yeah, jolly good time all round, I think. And following on from that, we're now moving on to DLC, which has got much better reviews. So join me next time, and we'll begin A Criminal Past. Thanks for watching, friends.